Today we are going to discuss second chapter of class 7 science, nutrition in animals. Let us have a look on the topics which we will cover in this chapter. First one, different ways of taking food. Second one, digestion in humans. Third one, digestion in grass-eating animals. Fourth and last one, feeding and digestion in amoeba. Plants can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis, but animals cannot. Animals get their food from plants either directly by eating plants or indirectly by eating animals that eat plants. Some animals eat both plants and animals. Recall that all organisms, including humans, require food for growth, repair, and functioning of the body. Animal nutrition includes nutrient requirement, mode of intake of food, and its utilization in the body. In your previous class, you have studied what are the components of food. Let us have a brief look on them. Food contains carbohydrates, protein, minerals, vitamins, water, and fat. The components of food, such as carbohydrates, are complex substances. These complex substances cannot be utilized as such. So they are broken down into simpler substances. The breakdown of complex components of food into simpler substances is called digestion. Do all animals take food in the same mode? Have a look how this frog is taking his food and judge what is the mode of taking food. Now have a look how this bee is taking food. This cow, what she is doing? Cow ruminating. Now have a look on this snake. Snake swallowing. The mode of taking food into the body varies in different organisms. Bees and hummingbird suck the nectar of plants. Infants of human and many other animals feed on mother's milk. Snake, like python, swallow the animals they prey upon. Some aquatic animals filter tiny food particles floating nearby and feed upon them. So there are many modes of taking food into the body, like scraping, chewing, siphoning, capturing and then swallowing, sponging, sucking are the mode of taking food in different organisms. Digestion in humans. We take in food through the mouth, digest and utilize it. The unused part of the food are defecated. Have you ever wondered that what happens to the food inside the body? The food passes through a continuous canal which begins at the buccal cavity and ends at the anus. This canal can be divided into various compartments, starting from buccal cavity and ending at the anus. First, from where this canal starts is called buccal cavity, then food pipe, middle portion is called stomach, then small intestine, then large intestine, which ends at rectum, and the last portion of this canal is called anus. Now we will discuss in detail these various compartments and the portions of these compartments. Let us start with the mouth buccal cavity. Food is taken into the body through the mouth. The process of taking food into the body is called ingestion. We chew the food with the teeth and break it down mechanically into small pieces. Teeth. Each tooth is rooted in a separate socket in the gums. Our teeth vary in appearance and perform different functions. Accordingly, they are given different names: molar, premolar, canine, and incisor. Different functions of our teeth we will discuss one by one. First one, let us see molar. The molars or molar teeth are large, flat teeth at the back of the mouth. They are more developed in mammals. They are used primarily to grind food during chewing. Premolar. The premolar teeth are transitional teeth located between the canine and molar teeth. In humans, there are two premolars per quadrant in the permanent set of teeth, making 8 premolars total in the mouth. The canine teeth are relatively long, pointed teeth. They are developed and are used primarily for firmly holding food in order to tear it apart, and occasionally as weapons. Incisor. The incisors are the front teeth present in most mammals. They are located in the front above jaw and on the front below jaw. Humans have a total of 8. They are developed and are used primarily for cutting. Salivary glands. Our mouth has salivary glands which secrete saliva. Do you know the action of saliva on food? Saliva is a watery substance formed in the mouth of animals, secreted by salivary glands. Human saliva comprises 98% water plus electrolytes, mucus, white blood cells, and epithelial cells. The enzymes found in saliva are essential in beginning the process of digestion of dietary starch and fats. These enzymes also play a role in breaking down food particles entrapped within dental crevices, thus protecting teeth from bacterial decay. Furthermore, saliva serves as a lubricative function, wetting food and permitting the initiation of swallowing and protecting the muscle surface of the oral cavity from desiccation. Tongue. Tongue is a fleshy muscular organ attached at the back to the floor of the buccal cavity. It is free at the front and can be moved in all directions. Functions of the tongue. We use our tongue for talking. Besides, it mixes saliva with the food during chewing and helps in swallowing food. We also taste food with our tongue. It has taste buds that detect different tastes of food. The food pipe. The swallowed food passes into the food pipe, which is also known as esophagus. The food pipe runs along the neck and the chest. Food is pushed down by movement of the walls of the food pipe Actually, this movement takes place throughout the alimentary canal and pushes the food downwards to the stomach. At the time, food is not accepted by our stomach and is vomited out. After food pipe, it's stomach. The stomach is a thick walled bag. Its shape is like a flattened U, and it is the widest part of the alimentary canal. It receives food from the food pipe at the one end and opens into the small intestine at the other. The inner lining of the stomach secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid, and digestive juices. The mucus protects the lining of the stomach. The acid kills many bacteria that enter along with the food and makes the medium in the stomach acidic and helps the digestive juices to act. The digestive juices break down the proteins into simpler substances in stomach. After stomach, the food enters the small intestine. The small intestine is a highly coiled and is about 7.5 meters long. It receives secretions from the liver and the pancreas. Beside it, its walls also secretes juices. The liver. Liver is a reddish brown gland situated in the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. It is the largest gland in the body. It secretes bile juice that is stored in a section called gallbladder. The bile plays an important role in the digestion of fats. Pancreas. The pancreas is a large cream-colored gland located just below the stomach. The pancreatic juice acts on carbohydrates, fats, and proteins and changes them into simpler forms. Then food reaches large intestine. The large intestine is wider and shorter than small intestine. It is about 1.5 meter in length. Its function is to absorb water and some salts from the undigested food material. The remaining waste passes into the rectum and remains there as semi-solid feces. The faecal matter is removed through the anus from time to time. This is called ejection. Have you observed cow, buffaloes, and other grass-eating animals chewing continuously even when they are not eating? Actually, they quickly swallow the grass and store it in a part of stomach called rumen. Here the food gets partially digested and is called cud. But later the cud returns to the mouth in small lumps and the animal chews it. This process is called rumination, and these animals are called ruminants. Ruminants have a large section-like structure called rumen between esophagus and the small intestine. The cellulose of the food is digested here by the action of certain bacteria, which is not present in humans. Feeding and digestion in amoeba. Amoeba is a microscopic single-celled organism found in pond water. Amoeba has a cell membrane, a rounded dense nucleus, and many small bubble-like vacuoles in its cytoplasm. Amoeba constantly changes its shape and position. It pushes out one or more fingers-like projections called pseudopodia or false feet for movement and capture of food. Amoeba feeds on some microscopic organism. When it senses food, it pushes out pseudopodia around the food particle and engulfs it. The food becomes trapped In a food, the vacuole, digestive juices are secreted into the food vacuole. They act on the food and break it down into the simpler substances. Gradually, the digestive food is absorbed. The absorbed substances are used for growth, maintenance, and multiplication. The undigested residue of the food is expelled outside by the vacuole. Now, just have a brief look on what you have studied in this chapter. Animal nutrition includes nutrient requirement, mode of intake of food, and its utilization in the body. Human digestive system consists of alimentary canal and secretory glands. It consists of the buccal cavity, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, ending in the rectum, and anus. The main digestive glands which secrete digestive juices are the salivary glands, the liver, and the pancreas. The stomach wall and the wall of the small intestine also secrete digestive juices. The mode of feeding vary in different organisms. Nutrition is a complex process involving ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and aggregation. Now here is an exercise for you. All students, you may note down these questions in your notebook and think for answers.